Hello friends, we'll take up a few problems from the model question bank on theory of simple bending and try to solve it. I have taken selected problem number 3. A steel plate is bent into a circular arc of radius 10 meters. A circular arc of 10 meters. The plate is 100 mm wide. And 15 mm thick. Assuming the value of E, Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity, as 2 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per mm square, find the maximum stress. Find the maximum stress induced in the plate and the value of bending moment which produced this stress. Right. Now, see, imagine that this is a metal strip. We are not bothered about its length. The width of the plate, this plate is 100 mm. The thickness or the depth of the plate is 15 mm. And it has been bent like this into an arc. We have bent it into an arc of radius 10 meters. A strip is taken, a strip of this, strip like this, and it is bent into an arc like this. Now he says, he has given all these dimensions. He says, find what is the stress induced in this and what is the bending moment to which it is subjected. Now this is to be converted into mm. This is 10 into 1000. That is 10,000 mm. 1 meter is 1000 mm. So 10,000 mm. These are given in proper units. What we want is F and M. Now we have this equation. M by I is equal to F by Y is equal to E by R. This is the equation. Now if we take these two, we know E, we know R. E is given, R is given. Y can be got, Y will be D by 2. So if we know Y, we can get this F taking this part. Then you take any one of these two or these two, you can get the value of M. Now I will be, moment of inertia will be BD cube by 12. So find out these values. D by 2 means 15 by 2. That is 7.5 millimeter, D is 15. BD cube by 12 means 100 into 15 cube divided by 12. That works out to 100 into 100 into 15 to the power of 3 divided by 12. That gives me 196.8 approximately, 196.8 mm to the power of 4. This is I. So now F by Y is equal to E by R. First I'll take like this. Now therefore F will be equal to E into Y divided by R. I want F. I know all the three. Substitute. This is 2 into 10 to the power of 5 into Y is 7.5 divided by this is 10,000. So 2 into 10 to the power of 5, 10 to the power of 5 multiplied by 7.5 divided by 10,000 will give me 150. The answer is 150 Newton per mm square is the unit because this is the stress. So F is got. Now after getting F, what we have to do is we take up one of these two. That is, I can take M by I is equal to F by Y, or I can take M by I is equal to E by R. So I want M. So M will be equal to F into I by Y. Now F I have got 150 into I is 196 point something divided by this is 7.5. 150 into 196.8 divided by 7.5 will give me 3936 Newton mm. This is the maximum bending moment induced in this. If you do the other way also, m is equal to E into I by R, that way also if you do, you will get the same answer. You can do it either way it can be done. Next, I am taking the next problem, problem number 4. Problem number 4 from question bank. From question bank, problem number 4. The moment of inertia of a beam section 500 mm deep. Question number 4. Depth is 500 mm. Moment of inertia of a beam whose section is 500 mm deep is 700 into 10 to the power of 6 mm to the power of 4 mm to the power of 4. Find the longest span over which a beam of this section, when simply supported, could carry a load of UDL of 40 kilonewton per meter. 40 kilonewton per meter. The maximum flange stress in the material is not to exceed 110 newton per mm square. This is the problem. Problem number 4. What he is asking? You have We have a simply supported beam. The simply supported beam means it has two supports at both extreme ends. Put a rough sketch. It's a simply supported beam. This is L. This is what we have to find out. What is the length? It is carrying a UDL. The UDL is 40 kilonewton or 40 into 10 to the power of 3 newton per meter. I have converted into newton per meter. 40 into 1000 newton per meter or 40 into 10 to the power of 3 newton per meter. This is D. So if I know D, I can get Y. It's a rectangular beam. Generally, it is rectangular. So D by 2, that is 500 divided by 2, that is 250 millimeter. This is the value of Y. Y is 250 mm. I is given. First, what I do, M by I is equal to F by Y. Now, he says I is given directly. F is given. I also know Y because I know D. I know these three quantities, so I can get M. First get M. M will be equal to F into I by Y or F into Z. So this is F is 110. I is 700 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by Y is 250. Y is 250. So now take calculator. 110 into 700 divided by 7.5. I will keep that 10 to the power of 6 as it is. So it will be 10266.6666. It will come 67 into 10 to the power of 6. So many newton millimeter. This is the bending moment. So much is the bending moment. Now for this particular case, it's a simply supported beam carrying a UDL throughout its span. we know m is equal to, for this, this is the fifth case I have given, m is equal to small w l square by 8 into 1000. This is the formula for m in that case. Now in this I know m, I have got m here, I have got w, w is given, I want to, he wants us to find out l. So l square will be equal to 8m divided by w into 1000, or l will be equal to square root of this, we'll make a substitution, l will be equal to square root of this, 8 into 10 to 66.67 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by w is 40,000 into this is 1000 as it is. Now l, this is, this will give me l square, square root of that will give me l. So I'll take the calculator now. This into 8, m into 8 divided by 40,000 divided by 1000 will give me something like this, 2.053 into 10 to the power of minus 3. No, there seems to be some mistake. 8 into 10266.67 into 10 to the power of 6. Divided by 40,000 divided by 1000 will give me 2053. This will give me 2053.33, something like that. This is L square. So L will be square root of this, square root of answer. Square root of answer will give me 45.3 meters. This is the longest span. You cannot have more than that. The maximum span that you can have is 45.3. If it is more than that, then it won't be able to take up that load. That is the problem. So that is the problem number 4. Next, I have taken one more, selected one more problem from the question bank. That is problem number 12. It says like this, a timber joist is freely supported and has a span of 6 meters. Means it is again simply supported beam of 6 meter span. If the UDL of 10 kN per meter and a point load of 5 kN at a 0.3.5 meter from left support is loaded, determine the dimensions of the beam. Assume depth of the beam as twice its breadth. A timber beam of span 6 meters, so this is 6 meter, it carries a UDL of 10 kilonewton per meter 10 kilonewton per meter, and it also carries a point load of 5 kilonewton at a point 3.5 meters from left support. It is not at the center, it is 3.5 meters here. This is then 2.5 meters. Then determine the dimensions of the beam. Assume depth, the dimension, this cross section of this will be like this. This is B, this is D. So I have got to find out B and D, width and depth of the beam. That is what we mean by dimensions of the beam. Assume depth of the beam is twice its breadth. D is equal to 2 times B. Take E as, F as 10 newton per mm square. That is allowable stress as 10 newton per mm square. Now, here, this load is 5 kilonewtons. So 5000 newtons. So now we will, it's a superimposed this thing. So same formula. Now bending moment due to UDL. UDL will be WL square by 8 into 1000. That is, W is 10,000, 10 kilonewton per meter, L is 6, so 6 square divided by 8 into 1000. This is M1, you can call it, M1. M1 will be 10,000 into 36. Into 1000 divided by 8. This will be 45 followed by 6 zeros, or 45 into 10 to the power of 6 newton mm. I'll call that as M2. Now bending moment due to point load. Now this will be 5000, no? 5000. Now if I take moment here, this into 6, RB, I'll take this as A, that as B. RB into 6 will be equal to RA into, 5000 into 3.5. So RB will be equal to 5000 into 3.5 divided by 6. So that will be 5000 newton. 5000 newton into 3.5 divided by 6. That will be 2916.7, and here it will be 5000 minus 2916.7, so 2083.3. Now I think the bending moment at the center, this is more. So 2916.7 into 6 meters divided by 2 will give me 8.75 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm due to this. This is M2. Now total bending moment M will be equal to M1 plus M2. That will be 45 plus 8, 53.75 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. This will be total bending moment. Now, after getting the total bending moment, you have F by, M is equal to F into Z. F into Z. Now, M is 53.75 into 10 to the power of 6 is equal to F is 10 into Z. So, Z will be equal to 53.75 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 10. 110 will get cancelled. So you get the value of Z, that is section modulus. Section modulus will be how much? Z is equal to 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5 mm cube. Now this Z is BD square by 6. For a rectangular section, it is BD square by 6 is equal to 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5. Now, here there are two unknowns, both B and D we don't know. That's why he says take D is equal to 2B. Either you substitute B in terms of D or D in terms of B. Anyway you will do, you will get one of them. So B into, instead of D square, I can write it as 2B the whole square divided by 6 is equal to 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5. So here you get B into 2B the whole square means it will be 4B square divided by 6 is equal to 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5. Then B cube will be equal to 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5 into 6 divided by 4. This 6 will come here, 4. So B will be equal to, B will be equal to cube root of 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5 into 6 divided by 4. So 53.75 into 10 to the power of 5 into 6 divided by 4 will give us this much, cube root of this. Cube root of this answer will be equal to 1193 mm. B is equal to 11193 point something, you can take it as 93.4 mm. You can take it as 1200 mm or 1.2 meters. D will be 2 times B, that is 2 into 1200, that is 2400 millimeter. That's it. This is D and that is B. These are the values of width and depth, dimensions of the beam section.